An official of the U.S. State Department expresses concern over China's use of intimidation in its maritime row with the Philippines. More from Bianca Dava.
Beijing accuses Washington anew of being a troublemaker in the South China Sea. This after the U.S. condemned China's latest maritime aggression against Philippine vessels that left 4 Filipino Navy personnel injured.
China urges the U.S. to refrain from using the Philippines as a pawn to destabilize the South China Sea. The Philippines also needs to refrain from being manipulated by the U.S. Lessons from history tell us that a pawn will only end up being abandoned.
The U.S. State Department meanwhile asserts Washington will maintain its presence in Southeast Asia.
The United States continues through our own operations to be physically present in the region on a daily basis, and we continue to fly, sail, and operate everywhere that international law allows, demonstrating thereby that all countries share those same rights.
The U.S. State Department also criticized China's recent actions as destabilizing.
I think we've seen in a number of instances where the People's Republic of China has taken a number of steps in the South China Sea that both run counter to international law, but that also utilize coercion to intimidate partners in ways that we find deeply unacceptable and destabilizing.
Meanwhile, the AFP Western Command reported a significant decrease in Chinese presence at the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal following last Tuesday's harassment of a military resupply mission. WESCOM Commander Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos says there are only one Chinese Coast Guard vessel and two Chinese militia vessels near the shoal as of Thursday morning, down from 26 last Tuesday. Carlos was on board Unaiza May 4 when it bore the brunt of a water cannon attack by the China Coast Guard on Tuesday, said the voyage aimed to check whether the vessel can enter the low tide elevation.
Ito yung first time sana na gagamitin natin. Itetest muna natin sana kung makakapasok sa Ayungin Shoal kasi deeper yung draft nito eh. Mas malalim than the other Unaiza May. Almost doble sa laki.
Although it was its first voyage to Ayungin Shoal, Unaiza May 4 had already been to two previous test missions in Cuyo and Balabac in Palawan. Carlos said the civilian boat is now undergoing repair.
Nothing major yung repair, only the replacement of yung windshield, madali lang naman yan. And then yung mga CCTV cameras na nasira, madali din naman palitan yan. Mabuti na kalagayan nila, sabi ko nga, minor injuries lang naman yan, napacheck na namin sa station hospital namin dito sa Westco. Minor din naman yung mga cuts nila sa mga braso, hindi naman sa delikadong lugar.
The AFP will stick to using Unaiza May boats in future resupply missions. Carlos added, Unaiza May 1, which was able to reach the BRP Sierra Madre in the last mission, is scheduled for repair as some parts of the boat have started to deteriorate. Unaiza May 2 is also still under repair after it was hit by the China Coast Guard in last year's mission.
Scheduled repairs lang siya na kailangan ng gawin, maintenance ng makina, some hull repairs, yung may mga medyo mahina ng parte ng hull na ababa na naman, above waterline, papalitan natin kasi kahoy siya. We have other options, pinag-aaralan namin. Ang una dyan is kung we will stick to the UMs, i-manage ka natin yung load in terms of frequency ng RORE, in terms of kung gaano karami ang ikakarga natin.
Carlos said the morale of his men remains high despite China's latest harassment. Meanwhile, two analysts agree with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement that the latest water cannon incident is not enough to invoke the country's mutual defense treaty with the United States.
Malinaw po nakalagay sa MDT at doon din sa mga statement ng US at Philippines since that time, no? Ang requirement po ay an armed attack, no? Armed attack on Philippine ships, troops or aircraft, no? So sa ngayon po, yung paggamit ng water cannon at na pagkabasag ng windshield, hindi pa po yun umaabot dun sa armed attack. Kung ibang pwede pang gawin ang Philippines and United States sa dahil sa mga ganyang klaseng activity. Kung ano po yun, ay hindi po yun parang kailangan pag-usapan sa publiko, no? Dahil ano nga naman, hindi naman pwede na bawat hakbang mo, eh, pinapasabi mo, pinapaalam mo agad sa kabila. I agree. Kasi yung MDT should be the last resort. Yung grabing-grabe na, wala ka nang maisip. Kasi right now, ang dami pa nating interventions. Unang-una, of course, no, yung diplomacy, yung tama yung ginagawa ng ating presidente ngayon. He's gaining support from Union of Like-Minded Countries. Hindi lang ang Estados Unidos yung gustong umalalay sa atin. Nandiyan na si Australia, si Japan, tapos yung European Union, tapos yung mga kapitbahay natin in Southeast Asia, lumalakas yung collective deterrence natin. Mm.
Despite the latest incident, the AFP and the Philippine Coast Guard stressed they will continue to bring supplies and to rotate troops at the BRP Sierra Madre and to maintain Philippine presence in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.
As tensions rise in the South China Sea, Chinese President Xi Jinping urges the country's military to prepare for maritime conflicts. He also said the military should be ready to protect Beijing's maritime rights and interests. He issued those orders during a meeting with the armed forces at this year's National People's Congress or the Chinese Parliament. Xi also called on the military to enhance strategic capabilities in cyberspace and to build a cyberspace defense system. Two Filipinos were killed in a Houthi missile attack on a commercial vessel in the Gulf of Aden. Here are the details.
Two Filipinos are among three seafarers confirmed dead in a Houthi missile attack on a bulk carrier navigating the Gulf of Aden. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega said the crew of the MV True Confidence was forced to abandon ship after it was engulfed in flames. Three other Filipino crew members who were injured in the attack are now being treated in a hospital in Djibouti. The vessel's 20-man crew was composed of 15 Filipinos, 4 Vietnamese, and 1 Indian national.
There are 3 injured Filipinos. We know one has burns on the face. And the other, apparently, I think it was the cook, had to be amputated. That's injuries. They're in the Djibouti hospital now. Tatlo and the other Filipinos.
The Philippine Embassy in Cairo will be sending representatives to facilitate the repatriation of 10 uninjured Filipino sailors.
The Philippine Embassy in Cairo is in charge of Djibouti. They'll have to send a team to work coordinated with, because ngayon wala silang papeles kasi sa rush, or maybe because the ship was burning, no? They left their papers.
The Philippine Migrant Workers Department did not disclose the names of the seafarers for privacy reasons, but it vowed to provide assistance to the families of the victims. It also reiterated its call for ship owners to avoid high-risk areas, particularly the Gulf of Aden and the Red Sea, where Houthi rebels have concentrated their maritime attacks. Philippine Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri condemned the deadly attack. He called it an act of terrorism, adding there is no justification for this brutality. These are the first fatalities reported since the Iran-aligned Yemeni group began strikes against ships passing through one of the world's busiest trade lanes. The U.S. State Department vows to hold the Houthis accountable.
The Houthis have continued to launch these reckless attacks with no regard for the well-being of innocent civilians who are transiting through the Red Sea. And now they have unfortunately and tragically killed innocent civilians. And so the United States will continue to hold the Houthis accountable for their attacks, which have not just disrupted international commerce, not just disrupted the freedom of navigation in international waters, and not just endangered seafarers, but now tragically killed a number of them. So we will continue to hold them accountable, and we call on governments around the world to do the same.
A spokesperson for the Houthi military said the vessel was attacked after it ignored warning messages from the Yemeni naval forces. In November last year, Houthi rebels seized the commercial vessel Galaxy Leader with 25 crew members on board. 17 of them are Filipinos. They are still being held hostage in Yemen.
11 Filipino crew members of a ship seized in January by the Iranian Navy are expected to return to the Philippines. This would leave 6 Filipinos aboard the St. Nicholas after one of its Filipino crew members was released last month. Iran's Navy seized the St. Nicholas after the U.S. allegedly stole Iranian oil.
11 sa kanila pinalitan na ng tripulante ng ibang bansa kasi yun ang demand natin, hindi other Filipinos, no? At papauwi na kasi nag-expire na yung contract. Itong linggo may darating na siyam, tapos next week may dalawa pa.